So guys, first of all, what exactly we will do is that you can see this is part 3 of API integration in Android app, and the first two parts are released. So if you want to see, so its link is available in description box. So for this, in this tutorial, what we will do now is simply, you can see that we have this API tutorial folder. So here you have to create another file, and that will be for deleting, because we will perform delete operations. So simply make it delete, and then after that here I will write php, and after that yes. So now you can see that we have the sign of this Internet Explorer or whatever you can say. So now we have delete.php file, so click on it and open with Sublime Text, and here we have the file. So now we will code that how can we delete data from our MySQL database. So first of all, we will do is come here and copy this code, Control plus C from get php, and then after that simply paste it here, and then after that you have to do is question mark, not like this, I mean question mark, and then close. So now php tag is closed. So inside it we can write the codes for deleting. So first of all, we will create the variable of name id, because we will use id for deleting, you can say, data from MySQL. So here you have to create a post. So first of all, we will create variable and using post method, and inside that we will give the value id, because we have to delete data using id. Then after that we will write a SQL query, and that will be quite simple. So between this quotation simply write caps lock delete, simple delete. After that from, now we will give table name. So let's see what is our table name. So here you can see that our table name is users. So after that here you have to open users, understand, and then after that caps lock w-h-e-r-e where, and then again small id, and this time id equals to single quotation, and you have to write id. Now after that in the ending semicolon. So now we have the SQL query. So after that we will create a variable for result, so we can identify that our code is a task is done or not. So after that write SQLi, mysqli underscore query query, now brackets inside it, simply first of all pass connection, and then pass SQL, and then semicolon. So this time now we will use a if and else. So if the result is successful, so it's okay, otherwise what we will do is we will simply echo, and that will be bracket, and here write data deleted, and then after that else, so after that here you can see that we have given the if and else statement. So after that I will simply write is mysqli, and now we will close the connection. So simply write close, close then bracket, and here you have to pass con connection, now semicolon. So I hope now our coding part is almost done, and if the result is successful, so we will show, we will echo message data deleted, if not so we will say failed. So I guess that is all for our PHP part, I mean API part. So after that you have to open Android Studio, and so after that we will proceed with this API application. So you can see that this is our show data activity. So here we have to perform some actions like edit, update, delete. So first of all here you have to declare a string, and that will be delete URL, and then equals to quotation, and just leave it for now. And now we can proceed inside this on create. So here you have to simply do is write list view, and then after that list view dot set on item click listener, and then after that new on click listener. So now we have this method. So inside it we can proceed. So after that here we will create a alert dialog in order to choose, then after that write dot builder, yeah now it's okay to code dot builder, and now we will create object for that, builder equals to new alert dialog builder. So simply write alert dialog builder, and here we have to simply pass is context. So write show data dot this, and then semicolon. So after that here you have to do is simply write char sequence, then semicolon, I mean brackets, and here you have to pass items, and that will be equals to, And here we will give the items. So first item will be edit data, and we will handle it in next tutorial. And after that, our next option will be delete data. So that is our, that's all. Now after that, simply write builder dot set title, and that will be, you can simply say data class array list dot get, and here you have to pass I because that is our position, and then dot get name, understand? And after that, close it. And then after that, again, we have to do is builder dot set items. So first of all, the item is going to be simply pass items. And then after that, new, and simply write dialog interface on click listener. And then after that, you have to simply implement semicolon, understand? Now inside this on click, what we will do is we will simply use a switch statement. So because we have multiple options like delete and edit, so first of all, we will start with this boolean. So it is for true. And now inside this, we will create a case. So first of all, case 0 means edit data. So after that, here you have to write break for ending that statement. And case 2 and another case 1 will be. So actually 0 and 1. So case 1 will be our delete data. So between it, you have to do is simply write delete data. And then after that, you have to semicolon, and inside it you have to pass data class array list, understand? And then simply write dot get and pass index I because that is our ID, I mean position. And then after that, you have to pass get ID and now semicolon, understand? So after that, click on this red bulb, create method, and simply choose last option, show data. And now here we have the method, understand? So inside it method, we can proceed. So after that, let me see the remaining part. So now we have created the switch successfully. And now after that, just after this semicolon, you just have to write is builder dot create dot show, and that's all. So after that, you have to proceed in this delete method. So here what exactly you have to do is just simply open your main activity, because there are some part of code that you can copy from here. Actually everything you can copy from here, simply copy it from here, and control plus C. If you don't know how to do this, just watch first part, then second, and then come on this third one. So after that, remove this third two parameters and just make it ID. And here you have to pass ID, that's all. And just for now, make it show data. And for error, that's okay. And just after that, just remove this code and to also comment this, it's not required. So now here we have to do a little work, and that is just we have to validate. So first of all, write if dot response equals ignore case, and here simply write what you have to write is open sublime text, and just copy it from here, and also add this semicolon, otherwise it will create problem, and then save it. So after that, simply copy this data deleted from here, control plus C, go back, and then Android Studio, and you have to paste it here. And then after that, if this is the case, so what we will do, we will show a toast message that successfully deleted, understand? And in the else part, you just have to show a message that failed, whatever you want to show. So just simply write failed. I will simply say that failed, that's okay, understand? So guys, now I hope our coding part is almost complete, and just change this context here too. So simply make it show data, not shortcuts, just show data. Now we have this. So now we can proceed to web host. So after that, just open Google, and make sure you save this file correctly, and our codes are almost correct. And make sure your username, your password, your database name, everything should be correct, because if this is wrong, so replication may not work, understand? So please try to make things clear. And you can see that this is our dashboard of web host. So here you have to click on this tools, and then after this I will open file manager, and I will go for upload files, then go back and click on this database manager. So here we can see our database, manage php my admin, and that's okay. So here click on this public HTML file. And now after that, here what exactly we have to do, you can see that we are already having two files, get php, insert php. So after that, I will upload a third file, delete php. So what here I will do is I will simply drag and drop, open this folder, and drag this delete php file, and open this, and yeah, delete, upload. Now it is uploading, uploaded 100%, and you can see the part is almost done. So I will click on this delete PHP and right click and view this file, and it will show failed. And there is something wrong. ID in delete PHP 4 data deleted. So let me see the error on 4. Well, for now let's just skip this, because we will try, so we will just run the application. If it will not work, so we will see. Otherwise, fourth number, everything is okay. Undefined index ID storage SSD 2 blah 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 delete.php on line 4 ID.php on line 4. So just leave it for now, understand? So after that, you just have to copy this and control plus C. Now go back in your Android Studio and you just have to paste that URL in this delete URL, understand? And then simply control plus V. Now we have this delete.php file. So now guys, it's time to run the application. So before that, what here you have to do is let me show you the changes that you have to make is here in this delete meta method here, you have to give this delete URL, understand? And open this edit file and just simply add this dollar sign here, understand? And after that, save this file and upload it in web host in this file manager here, understand? And all you can simply do is click on this edit button and you can add it just from here. So you can see that we have this dollar sign here, understand? Just over here, see, this is the dollar sign. And after that, close it. Now it's time to run the application and see is it working or not. So everything is okay. So here we have two data, Rajjan Parvez, understand? Male. So now I will run the application simply. And I will open this MySQL database, click on this button, show data. And here exactly we are having 21, actually two data. So I will click on this Parvez and I will delete data. Let's wait for the toast message. So successfully deleted, and when I will refresh the code, so Parvez should be removed from here successfully. So you can see that the Parvez is removed successfully. So you can see that our deleting API is working absolutely fine. So guys, if you like this tutorials, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. And you know guys, if you want the source code of this complete application and PHP file, so join membership, because I will provide source code by this tutorial when this tutorial is public. So trust, then it means that the source code is available. Join membership now. If you like this videos, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Thank you for watching.